I'm sitting here telling you this story because I don't want you to make the same mistake that I made. We live life and we can never turn back the hands of time. So cherish every moment that you have. I hope that my story here will help you and will inspire you to live your life to the fullest and to truly give your heart and your love and your time to those that you truly care about. Because you can never turn back time once it has moved forward. This is the story of my beautiful mother. When I was a young boy, my mom had only one eye. Oh, at the time I hated her so much for it. To me, she was such an embarrassment. My mom ran a small shop at a flea market. She collected little weeds and little flowers, anything that she could sell for money, just so she could pay the rent and feed me. To me, she was such an embarrassment. I still remember this one day during elementary school. It was field day, and my mom came. I was so embarrassed. I thought to myself, how could she do this to me? I threw her such a hateful look and ran out. The next day at school, all the children taunted me. They said to me, "Ew, your mom only has one eye. Ew." At that moment, I wished that my mom would have just disappeared from this world. So when I saw my mom that afternoon, I said to her, "Mom, why don't you just have the other eye? You're going to make me a laughingstock. Why don't you just disappear already?" My mom did not respond to me. I guess at the time, I felt a little bad. But at the same time, it also felt so good to think that I had said what I wanted to say all that time. That night, I woke up and went into the kitchen to get a glass of water. My mom was crying on the kitchen table so quietly, as if she was afraid that she might wake me. I took a long look at her, and then I turned away. Because of the thing I had said to her earlier, there was something pinching at me right in the corner of my heart. Even so, I hated my mother who was crying out of her one eye. So I told myself that night that I would grow up and become successful, because I hated how my mother only had one eye, and I hated our desperate poverty. I studied really hard from then on, and I moved out of state and got accepted into a very, very good university. Later, I met the woman of my dreams, and I was so happy. I got married and had two children, and I began to live life as a very successful man. One day, I stayed home from work because I wasn't feeling that well. I was laying down on the couch in the living room while my children were playing in their playroom. I heard a knock on my front door and got up to open the door to see who it was. Standing there was my mother, still with her one ugly eye. I looked at her and said, "What are you doing here? You are not welcomed at my house." At that moment, my daughter came running up to me and said, "Daddy, who is that?" I looked at her and said, "Honey, go back to your playroom. It's nobody. Daddy will take care of this." My mother glanced at me at that moment with tears in her eyes, and she said to me, "Oh, I'm so sorry. I must have the wrong house. Please forgive me. I won't trouble you. I'll be on my way." She turned around at that moment and walked down my porch and out into the driveway onto the street. 2 days later, I received a letter in the mail. It was a letter regarding a high school reunion. I lied to my wife at that moment and said to her that I was going on a business trip. After the reunion, I went to the old shack that my mother and I used to live in. Just out of curiosity, I wanted to see what she was doing and how she was living. I knocked on her door and nobody answered. So I slowly turned the doorknob and the door creaked open. I let myself in and called out to my mother, "Mom, Mom, are you here?" Nobody answered. I proceeded to walk through the whole house, and my mother was nowhere to be found. I walked around her neighborhood and asked to see if anybody knew what had happened to my mother. Eventually, I knocked on the door of one of her neighbors who knew her very well. She looked at me and asked me who I was, and I told her that I was Mary Sullivan's son. At that moment, her face turned into an expression of sorrow, and she said to me, "I'm so sorry. Your mother passed away yesterday. She died of a heart attack, but she left something for you. Just hold on 1 second. I'll go and get it." I stood there on the woman's front door and waited for her to come back. But as she was going into her living room, I took a peek in and I saw her pulling a piece of paper out of a brown dresser that she had in the living room. She proceeded to walk over towards me and handed me the white piece of paper. I extended my hand and received the paper that the woman had given me. Then I proceeded to leave her house and walked down the street. As I was walking down the street, I looked at the piece of paper in my hand and I proceeded to open it. It was a letter from my mother. The letter read, "My son, I think my life has been long enough now, and I won't visit you anymore. But would it be too much to ask one last time if I wanted you to just come to visit me once in a while? I miss you so much, my son. I was so glad when I heard you were coming for the reunion, but I decided not to go to the school just for you. I'm so sorry that I only have one eye and that I embarrassed you so much when you were growing up. You see, my son, when you were very little, you got into an accident and you lost your eye. As a mother, I couldn't stand around and watch you grow up with just one eye. So I decided to give you mine. I was so proud of my son, being able to see a whole new world for me and my place, that I was willing to sacrifice one of my eyes just for you. I was never upset at you for anything that you did. The couple times that you were angry with me, I thought to myself, it's because he loves me. Oh, how I miss the times when you were still young around me. I miss you so much. I love you. You mean the world to me. At that moment, my world shattered. And I hated the person that I had become. I cried, and I cried, and I cried so much for my mother. I couldn't stop crying for weeks, for months. And I didn't know why I hurt her the way that I did. And I wanted to turn back the hands of time, but I couldn't. Not a damn thing that I could do. I'm so sorry, Mom. So you see, I'm sitting here telling you this story because I couldn't love my mother the way that I should have. But I'm telling you this story, I hope that I can reach out to you and show you how much you should cherish your mother and your parents. Because when they're gone, you can never turn back the hands of time. I hope that you'll take this story to heart and go home and treasure the people that you love with all of your heart and share every single moment with them. Don't do it for anybody else, but do it for you and the people who truly love you.